Okay, my screen should be visible. Is my screen visible?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, great. So today we will be learning more about the web interface, how we can secure it using SSL, what SSL, and all the things related to SSL, how we can configure it in Weblogic. Or you can have the different kind of certs here. Okay, so we are using that today. And in last session we covered the security architecture. VMs, we created users and we created the bits as well. And we checked out different parameters and how we can have those like log and log the user. Those kind of security setting. We also check the different kind of roles which users can have, like operators and monitor and administrator like that. Okay, so today we will check out the SSL part. So basically, why we use SSL? We usually use SSL to protect ourselves from like to prevent any kind of hacking or any kind of security vulnerability or any kind of like if so that our data should be encrypted. That is the main purpose of this. So we checked that when we updated the boot.properties file, the file was, what was done to the file when the Weblogic restarted, the file was automatically encrypted. So why it was encrypted? To make it more secure. So that is the main thing, like it was encrypted. And but that encryption is only readable by Weblogic basically. So only Weblogic can encrypt or decrypt that particular file, right? So other users will not be able to read that file. They have even they have the access to that file, they will not be able to read the file, like what is the username and password value, that they will not be able to use that as well. And so that was the main primary purpose of ourselves encrypting that boot.properties property, so that no one, even if someone gets the access, he should not be able to log into Weblogic or do any operations using those encrypted credentials. That's why we do that. Okay. And what we can, similar concept is here as well, but here instead of using that encryption decryption facility of Weblogic, what we do is we have SSL configured here. So SSL is basically your secure socket layer. So it is basically a protocol which just like what how we did the encryption in boot.properties properties, similar this is in common platform or common protocols which are being used between different apps, like between browser, between web server, between app server, between many kind of devices and all the like websites and all. So they use this kind of SSL treatment. Okay. So basically if you see we have this so for all the secure websites we have this HTTPS. So for all like secure drive or secure protocol, this is the HTTPS. So your normal HTTP is unsecure protocol, okay? And HTTPS is secure protocol SSL. Fine. So even you can check out the properties of the certificate. So we will see that. So process of configuring secure socket layer is needed to protect you against attack against any application. So it is what is SSL? SSL is a protocol which enables connection security through encryption. So your connection between the client and the your application server or web server, so wherever you are trying the SSL, so connection between those two devices will be encrypted, and once it will be encrypted, it can be only decrypted by the client and server. So no one in between the client and server will be able to decrypt the application. And why that is necessary for us? Because we don't want anyone else apart from client and server to decrypt the values and see the values, because the data might contain like some password details or credit card details, credit card pins or some critical passwords and all. That's why it's recommended to have encryption between end to end, so between user and server. So SSL enables a server to authenticate to a client and a client to authenticate to a server. And data integrity, so that data that flows between a client and a server is protected from tampering by a third party. So it allows the server to authenticate to a client that the request which is coming from the server is proper. And it also allows a client to authenticate to a server, which is like your two-way SSL. So a server to authenticate to a client is one-way SSL, and a client to authenticate to a server is two-way SSL. And also like data integrity, because whatever data is going from the client, it is reaching to the server, and whatever going from server is the client. So there is data integrity, and the data is protected from outside eyes. So what are the main steps which we need to perform for SSL? So first thing we need to do is we need to enable the SSL port in your managed server. Okay, provide the SSL port in the configuration. SSL port is like similar thing, just what you, it's just a port number. 443 is the default port number, and there are other like so there is no specification or anything for end port numbers. You can give anything, but like if you want to have some like common, you want to make it a standard, then if you can use more than like similar to 443, then because 443 is the default secure port which browser takes, in which case you don't have to append it to the browser URL. Sahadev is asking why mute button is not working. I think.
Yeah, just wondering, you know, you guys may feel disturbance, background disturbance from my side, you know.
Okay, I'm seeing. Okay.
Can you control my microphone over there, you know, as a presenter?
It is saying you are not connected to audio. So
I'm connected with from the phone, you know.
Okay. But I don't have option to mute you because it is saying you are not connected to audio. But anyhow, we are not yet disturbed.
Okay.
Okay, so this is the main steps. Yeah, you wanted to write something. So for HTTP, okay, 80 is the default port. And for HTTPS, the default port is 443. Okay, there is no zero actually. Okay, so HTTP is 80. So even if we see here, we have the HTTPS, so we have not given anything here, right? After google.com, there is nothing here because the request is directly going to the server on port 443. So even if I write 443 here, it will work. Okay, because this S means 443 by default, unless you specify any port here. Suppose if I give 443.1, then it will should show some error, because now it is for secure protocol, it is looking for this port on this host. So it should not be able to find that, so that's why it will time out. It's going good. Okay. Now see, it's not working. So we can change it to 443. Okay. So the port number is already not showing here because 443 is the default one. And so if I go to google.com, it is going to 443 protocol, which is by default your secure protocol. Now let's check out the unsecure protocol, but still again it will redirect to SSL only because we have implemented the SSL all over the site. So even if you go to the default port, which is 80, for unsecure traffic, Google will take you to the their secure website. So they have like make it mandatory so that users, all the data, all the searches are encrypted. Any questions till now? So after enabling SSL port, first again we need to configure the identity and trust store. Okay. Okay, so identity is basically the identity of your server, and that is like in the form of keys, private key, public keys and all. And your trust store is where you keep the certificates which can be trusted by your Weblogic or client. So those are trust, those certificates are stored in where? The trust store. So what actually we need to do is we need to generate a private key, okay, and store in key store. Then we need to create a CSR, and what is a CSR? To CA, which will send us the signed certificate. So CSR is basically your certificate signing . So when you raise a CSR, the request is sent to the nearest
Honors.
Yeah.
How are you doing this in our console?
Some things in console and some things from the backend.
But I haven't seen anybody's console yet. Like how are we doing?
Yeah. What?
Like I haven't seen the anybody's console. So.
This SSL thing.
What do we configure SSL?
Just a second. Oops, I was experiencing some technical problem. Yeah, Binod, what you were saying exactly?
You talking about the SSL right now, right?
Yeah.
Do we have to do the SSL in the, console somewhere configured?
Yes.
Which screen? I was kind of lost right now.
See, why we do that is, you are seeing this, right? This website is using HTTPS. If we want to use HTTP only, okay, then the SSL is not in scope, okay. But if your application is mission critical, it is dealing with credit cards, it's dealing with money, it's dealing with critical user information, user credentials, username, passwords, and everything. So what means that is your application is quite critical and you need to have that application available in a secure form.
Secure server?
Yeah, SSL. So you need to configure that in such a way that whenever your users access the URL, the URL changes to HTTPS.
Okay.
So your HTTPS is encrypted.
Which is default by 443, you said, right?
Yes, so 443 is default for secure and port 80 is default for non-secure.
Okay.
So the only thing which changes is if, so only after host name you give a colon and the port name. So if right now my URL is this, so this is equal to, this is equal to 443. So 443 is default port, so it is not showing in the URL. So let's see, if I give 443, then the URL is working. Let's go, let's give 441, okay, 442. So what it will do is, it will check for this SSL port, but right now we don't have this particular port in running for this server. So it will time out. See, it's not working. It will keep on running like that only. That's the main utility of SSL. So it gives you an end-to-end encryption between user and server.
So we have to configure the SSL secure server through a console while we deploy application.
Yes, actually, we need to do it from console as well, and from, we can also do it from the back end.
Was it in the previous class?
Previous class, we only have the like, username and passwords, user VMs, and all. So there was nothing related to SSL there.
So we're doing the second one today.
Sorry?
We are doing the second one, the configuring SSL for Weblogic server.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
We will be doing one, okay. So now you understand the difference between secure and unsecured URL. So whenever you see a green button here, which is saying HTTPS and it is green, okay, that means we are good. Even you can check the certificate validity. It's assigned by a certificate authority. So if you go to certificate information, you will see the identity of has been verified by Google. Okay, all the site information and error, most of the things are available here. So even if you like go to those connection details, then check out for certification info. So this is the certificate which Google is using. So this is the detail they have given, that it is valid from 20th March to 23 June 2015. Here are the more detailed description of the certificates. So here you can see the different values of the certificate which is currently in use. So similar kind of certificates you can also have in the Weblogic. These are different key names and the key folders as well. Which we see. And this is the algorithm, the key usage, SAN name. What is the public key, what is the subject, public key, and yeah, the issue is this. Okay, so let's go here. So these are the basic steps. First we need to generate the private key, okay, and store it in key store then you need to create a corresponding CSR which will be sent to CA, which is your certificate authority, and then they will send you the digitally signed certificate. And then after that, what we need to do is we need to just import the self-signed certificate which created. We just need to do one thing, just import the certificate. That's not something big. So any questions still here? So enabling just the port is not mandatory, right, but we need to have separate meters as well. Okay. So how we perform these all steps? We use a utility which is key tool. So from where we can get the key tool? A key tool is a standard J2SE. It is an SDK utility which we manage. That is part of the standard JDK version. Whatever JDK version like you have, you will find the key tool command in that. Or like it is too much rush, so mostly some time you have, but yeah, mostly. So how you can use the key tool utility? So why we use key tool? Because it allows us to generate private keys and then generate the corresponding digital certificates. So, yeah. So what are the benefits? It allows you for the generation of, you can create the private keys and you can get the corresponding digital certificates.
So all this is our job, or this is the one who works with, you know, like to maintain the hackers. Isn't this to protect from the attackers?
See, that is basically if you are using SSL. Or if like that means you are using secure layer, what happens in that case is that your all the user data, like suppose the data has credit card details in the request and we do not want other users to access that particular information, so what we do in that case is that we have to create private keys, corresponding digital certificates, okay, and we need to create private keys, digital certificates, their key stores, and the key tool is the very versatile, you can say, right? Thank you. So I don't think anyone of you have worked on key tool, right?
What tool?
A key tool that is in Java. Java SSL tool.
Is it in the console or is it a separate?
Yeah, it is in the console, but to check all the server and all the credentials and everything, the what happens in that case is, okay, key tool can display all the certificates and whatever be the room contains. Key store, okay, whatever the key store contains, it will show you. Okay, so any queries in the slide?
We would be doing like a hands-on-hand with this stuff, right?
Okay, so these are basically the commands which we use. So these are the different commands, basically. So the command, the descriptions are mentioned, right? And let's check out the flow basically. Okay. What is actually happening in the background is that you might need to see, like you can see some kind of videos and all. So this is the HTTPS. So here we can see there is a lock item coming, so let's go through this section. Check HTTPS 443 and 480. Okay. Okay, so here is the certificate information for Google website. So even if you open any kind of web application or the URL which is better managed server, what happens in that case is you can have like different kinds of certificates for that.
So this configuration comes when we deploy the application.
I'm sorry, can you come again?
Like you know the configuration that SSL secured server link, right? Secure server link. Hello.
Yeah, sorry, tell me, I'm just looking into this. So this is the kind of seek you can say to seek today. Okay, encrypted value which you will be receiving. Okay, then you need to upload this into the IPMI directory as advised. What else we have? So that's why like the key tool utility provides us many benefits. So there are the different SSL commands which we can use in the at the back end. So we will see how you can execute it from the backend. You can check out the all the server details and okay, and the component type. Okay, so that's why K2 is basically we using mostly the logic. Okay, so anyone have other layer on like public key, private key, setting up keys?
What on is your mic? Your volume is not coming clear.
Yeah, just a second.
Anyone what?
Hello.
Yeah.
Is it fine now?
Yeah, now it's kind of clear. Earlier I couldn't understand what you were saying.
Okay, yeah. So I was asking like if anyone of you have worked on a key tool, like not on key tool but on like this public keys, what are public key, what are private keys, how to set up the keys between one server and another server.
Yeah, I was asking earlier about the, you know, like SSL.
Mm-hmm.
Like when do we configure the SSL? Is it when we deploy the application in the server, like you know,
mm-hmm.
and we configure the secure server, you know, the keys.
Yeah. And you need to configure the key basically. See, there are different kind of keys basically. So first thing, what keys here we are discussing, those are the Weblogic certificates.
Mm-hmm.
But the concept of public and private keys is still here. Okay, so let me explain it a bit. So suppose I have who shall I make the presenter? Vinod or Amit?
Yeah, I can do it if it's okay.
Can you share your screen? Can go to terminal.
So where do we go from here?
Yep. Just run, go to your home directory, cd.
cd home slash, right?
Or you can just write cd, it will go there. So.
Okay.
Okay, so right now you are in home directory itself. Now run the command which I posted.
Public private RSA key pair, enter file in which to save the key.
Just press enter. Well, we are not creating any password.
The same place again.
Yeah, just hit enter. So, empty passwords. Okay, write ls-lart.
L-A-R-T?
L-A-R-T, yep. A is for basically hidden files.
Oh, okay. So now you're telling us.
Sorry?
We didn't know about that before.
No, actually hyphen A is for hidden files.
Oh.
Yeah. Starting with dot L is for the list and T is for the time. So now we are in just cd2 dot ssh. So actually it's an Unix utility, so it's already, I guess, if you might have practiced with that Unix reference commands, would be there. So now here we can see we have two files, id underscore rsa and id underscore rsa dot pub.
Mm-hmm.
Fine.
Yeah.
So now this is your id underscore rsa is your private key and its permission is only 60. So that means only you can read it, you can write it, but other than you, no one can access it.
Mm-hmm.
And each private key has a corresponding public key as well. So dot pub is your public key.
Oh.
So it's like id underscore rsa is the lock, id underscore rsa is the pub file. So for every transaction the key and lock has to come together so that the connection can be established. So what usually we do is, this is like not related to SSL what we are learning, but the concept here remains the same of public key and private key. So how the communication between two different servers is established without using the credentials. We can communicate without giving any credentials. We can do that only via this public and private key combination. Okay.
So the public and private keys always by default stays together, right?
No. Actually, why we have this id dot pub file, only ID underscore RSA, which is your private key. ID underscore RSA, your private key, and it will remain at the same location where you have generated it. It will be stored here itself always, and you do not have to like share it with anyone else. So it's the most secret. So if any attacker or any hacker gets the access of your ID underscore RSA file, which is a private key, then he can compromise your whole server very easily.
Wow.
Because if you have the private key, then you do not need to know any username and password for that particular physical server. So right now, you when you log into Unix or anyone, you log in with your passwords and all. But if you have key set up, then you do not need to give password. The keys take care of everything.
Or do we learn how to set up a key so we don't have to give a password, or we don't do that?
Yeah. See, you already have these keys right now in front of you. So you have the private key and the public key. Now what you need to do is just you need to update the destination. So there must be some source and destination which you want to have the encrypted. Okay, keyless entry, you can say. So for that, what you need to do is you need to copy this .pub file contents into one file in another server where you are getting connected.
To do CP.
No, not like that. Let's do one thing. Amit, can you? Okay, here just write that if config, let's figure out your IP. It was if config, IF.
Oh. So the IP config is in the Microsoft Word, right?
Yep. Right. I will just go and have some water. It will take 2 minutes. Okay. Is that fine?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. We'll join in 2 minutes. I'll just go grab some water.
Okay.
Okay. Sure.
Without recording.
Yeah. Fine.
Okay.
Okay, Vinod. So right now we were like trying to figure out how we can have this. Is so we here we created the public key, private key, and public key combination. Okay, so we have one private key which was your this ID underscore RSA, okay, and .pub was your public key. So public key, as the name implies, public key is distributed to any public where you want to connect. Okay, suppose you want to connect to I can say Amit Ubuntu server, and you do not want to give any username or you do not want to give any password, then you need to provide the public key file to Amit. Okay, so can you show me the output of if config? Okay, 192.168.0.33. Or you can do one thing. Can you just go to Google Chrome and find out your IP? Just search what is my IP.
Or is this is my IP 260.6.0.0.0?
Yeah, it seems to be IPv6.
Like this long is my IP.
Yeah, this is IPv6 actually, because most I think you are using IPv6, so that's why it's coming so long. Okay, Amit, can you run the same in your Google Chrome? What is my IP? And ping in the chat. Amit?
Yes.
Okay, sure.
So why do we do this, Anuj, basically?
You will automatically understand it, like, once we do that.
Okay. That's Amit's IP.
Okay, he is using IPv4, that's why. Just ping ping from here, go into a terminal and ping this IP, ping and the IP name.
In my terminal?
Yeah, in terminal. We are just seeing if we are able to connect to Amit server.
Post to?
No, not equal to, just ping and the IP, Amit's IP.
Ping is IP, right?
Yeah. No, not your Amit 76.183. Yep. Okay, so it's available, right? Okay. Yeah, press Control C. So do one thing, now connect to this IP, SSH. Now we will try to remotely log into this IP, okay? So, I think the username is Amit, right? Amit for your PC? Okay.
Yeah.
And SSH? Yeah, Binod.
Yeah.
Yeah, now write the command SSH.
SSH.
Username is Amit, space Amit.
Capital A or small a?
Yeah, small I guess
a small a. Amit?
At the rate, same IP, 76.183.
Okay. No need commas and brackets?
No need. Just hit enter. It will ask the Amit's password on Amit's server.
Amit?
Yes.
You get a password? Password for what? My Wi-Fi password or Weblogic password?
Your PC password basically, like when you log into Ubuntu.
Nepal 123. No, I mean, I thought Amit will be asked, right? Not me.
No. Amit, it will ask us only.
Nepal 123 password.
I put password on it?
Yeah.
But it is not asking for password.
It's not asking.
Yeah, actually it shouldn't have been asking.
So 15 receive, 15 packet transmission receive 0% packet loss.
Amit, can you again check your IP? Is your IP changed or it is still the same?
It shows 76.183.87.116.
It is still the same. Okay, the problem is you know, SSH is not working. Press Ctrl C.
Connection timeout. Do it again.
Yeah, so can you run again that command ping 76? Yeah. Okay, press Ctrl C. Just a Okay, so the problem might be that SSH might be not running on me. I need to like separately install that one. But usually on what you can say, servers, you have SSH daemons running, but it seems it's not here. No, that's fine. Actually, what would have happened was, if you would try right now SSH to omit that particular IP, then then in that case, it will ask you the password of Amit, okay? But since you are connecting from this user, Binod, and you have set up the public and private keys, you can give this public IP to Amit. So he will put this .pub content in a authorized key files. He will create a file. Okay, and he will update the .pub content there. So what will happen is, next time when you run this command ssh amit at the rate interface, it will go to Amit server with your private key, okay? And it will see if there is any public key, corresponding public key is present. So right now we have copied public key of yours already on Amit server, so it will automatically authenticate. It will not ask for the password. So that is the purpose of private key and public keys in Unix. Okay, but here the our scenario is somewhat a little bit different, but again we still have that you can say what public key and private key concepts in Weblogic, SSL or any kind of SSL, we have the same concept. So this thing you can like practice later for creating SSH keyless entry. So this is your SSH keyless entry, which we almost completed till half. Okay, only like the few changes were pending at Amit's, but it seems SSH is not working in Amit's. So maybe we might need to like configure SSH there before we can send the request from here. Okay, so any queries or we can go ahead?
No.
Okay, let me make the presenter. So what we did earlier was we created a public key and private key combination, right? And the public key we need to distribute it to the other users. Okay, so what happens is first you create a private key and a public key combo in your with key tool in Weblogic key stores. Okay, so how you do that? The first command which is given here, it is saying okay, key tool gen key key store, then key store name and hyphen store pass and the key store password. So here we are creating a new private key entry. Okay, and the new private key entry is stored in the key store name which we specify here. So whatever the key store path and the name you are assigning here, okay, so those key stored, all the your keys and everything are stored in that particular key store as the name suggests. So it is an just like some box you have in your homes where you keep up something. So it's like the same thing. You have a key store password where its main purpose to store the like public keys, private keys and everything. And then what you need to do is you need to create a certificate signing request, and when you create a certificate signing request, that is a like encrypted file which is created, okay, corresponding to the private key which you have created in the first command. So you create a corresponding entry from the private key, and that is called CSR, but that is certificate signing request, and then you send this CSR file because you cannot send your private key, right? This private key has to be very confident and only user should be able to access to that. So that's why we give the permission as 600. So if you change the permission to 655 or like 677 or any 7, okay, that will cause a problem. So for each private key, you create a certificate signing request, which is a CSR. Then you take that CSR file, okay, and then submit it to some certificate authority like CA, there is CA, okay, there is GoDaddy, and there are many other hosting websites which provide you many kind of SSL certificate. So we can do that, okay. And once you create a certificate signing request, okay, so what happens is that is the certificate private key and public key combination, okay, is stored in the key store. Is it fine or we shall be a little more slow? Actually, this thing is more, the theory is like quite tricky, so you can only understand once you like physically do it. How it works actually. So when you create a CSR is basically for certificate, so you are signing the your private key in a new format, and that is sent to your CA, which is certificate authority, like VeriSign, GoDaddy and all. So they will send you a digital certificate, and then you need to import that Weblogic, that certificate into the your key store. So we have the commands to generate a CSR, we have command to create a private key, and then we have a command to list all the certs, then we have a command to delete any particular alias, okay, and we have like this key tool help as well, in which we can like, okay, provide only online help to your key tool, so that it's like similar to other help which we had, so we can create that. So if you need any kind of help or key tool, you can always run this key tool hyphen help command.
So when do we need those certificates?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. We do need that certificate in this case. See. So okay, suppose we are logged into Facebook. Right now it is going to HTTPS. Let's make it HTTP. Still it is going there. Okay, so here you can see HTTPS, S is for secure, okay, right? Suppose I am giving something very confidential here, so like this is my, you can say anything which I want to keep it confidential, right? So, this is your secure connection. So what is happening actually is whatever you are searching here, okay, this is encrypted here, and then the request is flowing through the web server to app server, and the so between this page which we have open here and the page from where it is coming, from the server where it is coming, it is protected via HTTPS. Protected means it is encrypted so that no one else can read without decrypting, no one else should be able to access it. So here if you see that, okay, let's check out the certificate detail. So this is certificate which is issued by Google to Google itself, and this is valid for 3 months. This certificate power SHA-1. So these are different things basically in a certificate. So did I made any sense, like how the SSL connection works, how you create a generate a private key, then how you create a CSR, how you get the cert for VeriSign, and then like the VeriSign sanction certs which you import in your application server. Binod, Amit, any questions? As we move ahead.
So I understood like HTTPS is a secured server where the other people cannot access the, you know, information about the, you know, like your company or your whatever in the server, because it's a secure server, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
But the thing is, how do we configure that? Do we configure that you will just do it by default when we deploy any application? Like if we deploy application in our server and I don't want user access my, you know, lot of information about the application beside they can just use it, you know. So how do we set up the SSL? Like do we set up before we deploy or after we deploy, you know, what, how do we do it, you know, like practically, you know, like we don't have to do it, or is it like by default it's secured, or you know, like we do we have to set up one time or we have to set up every time we deploy any application, you know? Are you up?
Yeah, sorry, I wasn't sure why the voice was going. So basically, we know what I understood you are saying, like if there is a requirement from the user, if they want to protect their application, how we can do that, right?
yeah, something like that.
Okay. Because that was a long question and that's what I summarized. So yeah, that is the main theory. So what you will, for that actually we need to first have key stores, okay? Key stores are there where we will have the our public key and private keys defined. So we will generate private key there, then we will create a CSR, okay? then using that CSR, you send that particular CSR to your certificate authority, like VeriSign, there is GoDaddy, and many like certificate providers, and they want your CSR. So once you send them the CSR, they will send you a certificate. Then you implement that certificate in your Weblogic application server.
So that's our job?
Yes, it's our job only.
So the keys to what is that keys to, is it part of a Weblogic, or we have to download it or separately or purchase it separately?
No, it's part of Weblogic only. Nothing needs to be purchased separately except the certificates. So if you want, because if I see that, let's go to some other website.
So that certificate is for only one server, one machine, or the company will buy a certificate for the whole company, and we don't have to do nothing. And whatever we do is in the secured server, because the company already bought our certificates. What is it like on it?
Usually what companies do, they have like a contract with these firms, okay? So they usually buy bulk certificates and all, but certificates usually have a particular like time limit. So some might be available for only 6 months, some might be available for 1 month, for 1 year. So you need to continuously renew them every year. So just like your car insurance expires every year, so you have to like buy every time before it expires. So similar thing is here.
So that buying takes place by the company for us?
That depends on like organization to organization and project to project. So if only you guys are taking care of it, then probably you guys, and if there is a separate team for that, then probably they will. So they will just order maybe, but definitely you will get the certs, and then you need to implement those in Weblogic.
So we implement that certificate for each server or each machine, each application that we deploy, that has to be certified, so the information, the user or hacker can access the, you know, critical information about that application. You know, how do we do it, you know?
Yes, you'll see that. So let me make Vinod you the presenter. Okay, we have the presenter now. When you screen, go to terminal, Weblogic console.
I mean, not.
Yeah. Now, okay, one is an admin, Amit is running.
Why is this server do not have machine associated with it, but I already have a no-hop started, so why is it saying this thing, you know?
Because NIGOO doesn't have any machine associated with it right now.
Well, but I started with a no hop, so do I need a machine even if I don't have a machine?
Yeah, only if you want to start it again from the console. Right now it is shut down, so if you want to like have it running in admin administrator, like running mode, the normal mode, then you need to run the start command again.
So I gotta start from here.
Yeah, into that as well.
Cause I try to do it, it's not letting me, no. Okay, right here, look. Right here, I don't have a... Okay, you said you have to restart from here, right? Since I created no hop.
Yep, there must be. But you're starting start Niku something, right?
Yeah, but okay, I did with this because it's a no hop is associated, right? Pending out.
Start them research. Okay.
No hop pending output to no hop dot output. So what do I do? Like just enter?
Yeah, you can just press enter. And the control C. Okay. Now let's check out what all processes are listening there. Let's check out these things here in DST.
I have another one. You know this Amit one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Amit one, I can't see in here. What is it? Let's see. Let's see, Amit one. Server. Right here.
But you are trying to start zim.sh. The server name which you have in the console is different, but and is node manager running?
Yeah. So that this one is node manager.
Okay, just do one thing. Go to console.
Where?
Console. Terminal, the admin console. Okay, so let's check. Amit, let's go to Amit. Amit, just about this. So right now your SSL listen port is not enabled, right? So you can, yeah, just lock and edit and change it. Yeah, so 7,204. Now click activate changes. Okay, now bounce the server.
And you said the admin state is the running state or not running state?
I forgot. Admin is not running, means app is not running, even though the JVM is up and running, but usually in this case the JVM did not take any much traffic. So that so also this shows that there is something wrong with the configuration thing.
So this is enabled?
Okay, so you have enabled SSL 4. Now go to deployments tab. So we have changed only for ABC right now, right?
Yeah.
Taking forever. See, both of these is in admin state.
Yeah. So these is fine. Just click on deployments tab.
Deployment.
Yep.
Yeah, I did already.
You're in deployments right now?
Yeah.
Okay. Can you check if any one of the application is connected to what target? If it had the target as 1 GB. Or at least one server like ABC, which we just configured.
Yeah, it says advertisement clusters, all server in the cluster part ABC and M1 and saw that. Can you see my screen?
Yeah. Right now, I've restarted ABC, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine, from there. And we made that SSL change for ABC, right?
Mm-hmm. An unexpected exception has occurred processing your request. Edit save change failed exception. Cannot save change in process.
Okay, so it will seem that some changes were already installed from progress. Click on active changes again.
What is it?
Okay, not sure whether it is coming. Okay, you can try one thing. You already like restarted the app server as well, right?
Mm-hmm.
So only Nico is shut down. And ABC is an admin state. That is precisely one. Okay, now can you try hit the app URL?
Which one?
The application URL.
Getting slow.
Yeah, it can have a good time. Okay, so it was not 7001. port, give the port of the managed server. We can take ABC, which is the name ABC.
It's 7002, right?
No. Check the port for 7002.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Why is doing 7001?
No.
It's changing to 1. You know, every time I enter, it's changing to 1.
It is
not.
It is still going to 7000, not going to 7002. Okay, so here we can see the SSL port is 7003.
This is a legion port. SSL port is 7002.
Yeah. We are just trying to see first if the recent port is working or not, because only if that is working, then only it's like fruitful to have other link check as well.
Why is not taking 7002?
Because you have not defined 7002 anywhere, right?
See, 7002. What is it? Advertisement.
Oh yeah.
Advertisement application.
Sorry, can you come again? No, the port was 7003, right?
It was, 7003 was the legion address. Anyways, Anuj, I'll do this later. Let's do the one we're trying to do.
Sure. So what you actually, you just need to do that thing. You already have done most of the things. So once done with that, you can, hey, when you hit the app, then it will go through the SSL certificate, which you might just have created and updated in the key stores. So I will give you a link as well with which you can get it from an Oracle website. In that you can configure we discussed how we need to gather the certificates from certificate authority, what CSR we need to give to them. Okay. So that thing actually you can only learn on the job training. So because that depends on every project, every organization, so that process is different. But yeah, the concept remains same. You create a private key, you create a corresponding certificate signing request, that is CSR. You send CSR to Okay. Let's just one thing is pending in that, so let's quickly cover that. Let me make a presenter. Okay, my screen to be visible now. Okay, so as I told, we have two kind of key stores here. So one is identity and another is trust key store. So as the name implies, trust key store is to have some, usually the public keys and also of all like major the ISPs and everyone. So they clearly already they're maintaining that thing. So what are identity and trust key store? So whenever you need to configure SSL, you have to decide how, where and will be identity, means your identity, where it will be stored, your private key. So once you have like, once you have created that, then you need to create a trust key store. And why we use trust key store? To have like some trusted old intermediate certs and all CA certificates like which have long validity period, but for like most your app related certificates you have this, you create the identity trust certs. So today you can try creating this identity and trust key store. The details are here. You can have identity key store. You can set the passwords. You can give the path and everything. And then whatever name you are giving for the key store, okay, whatever name you are giving for the key store, you can use the same key store password and key store credentials as using in the this. Key store name will be your key store name and this your key store password will be your key store password, which changes as per the definition which you might have defined them. So okay. So this is how like mostly your SSL thing works, but I think you guys need more insights. And once you create self signed certificates, you will be like able to digest it like more how it actually works. Because right now we have only checked the theoretical part, the main implication, how it works and like how it's encrypted, all the data and how the requests are coming on due to the, you can say where we have the key stores and everything. So how we are storing all the keys, keys and everything there, how we can view those particular keys and all kind of those details you can grab from the PowerPoint, and there are like more details as well corresponding to same. What are trust scores and everything, so those details also there. And if you have, so we will have more details tomorrow as well for the same session. So tomorrow we will see how today you guys can try, and tomorrow if it is not able to do that, then we will check that. Okay.
So today is okay, but tomorrow we can do it practically, right?
Yes, because we don't have much time, so it will not be possible for us to do.
Okay. Right now, like I'm kind of confused. Like thank you telling you because it's all theory. Maybe if we practically, maybe we'll be clear. And why do we need it? When do we make a certificate? You know, like all that thing. Like do we have to make a certificate for each application that we deploy, or we make one certificate for our own machine? Like everything. Like I have a lot of questions. Like you know, like if you can explain tomorrow, you know.
Yeah. As soon as we saw one example, most of your queries will be solved automatically, and then rest of the queries you can take after that thing.
Yeah.
Because we have only one session left after this, which is for Java message service, and so that will be the last topic, and we have like couple of questions which you guys asked, so we will be having a couple of sessions for that as well. We will be seeing Apache clustering, which is still pending. Once we are done with Java message service setup, then we will check out the Apache clustering and all, and tomorrow we will be checking for this SSL certificate self signed. Right now we will not be ordering certificates from a VeriSign, so we will, but yeah, we can always create some self-signed certificates which are not accepted by anyone. So in your browser you will not see this green icon. You see here the green icon, that means it is a trusted certificate, it's all green. But if you have any other URL name, then this icon will not be green. In that case, you need to check.
Okay.
So in case of self-signed certificates, it will clearly give you an warning that you are using self-signed certificates. That means the site is not trusted. But if you have this green proper certificate from certificate vendors that you have purchased, so in that case it will show everything as green, that means we are good. So tomorrow we will see for self-signed certificate, as the process doesn't have much difference. And you can go through the link which is mentioned at the end. You guys can check this as well in the free time. So we will be following like kind of similar steps. Okay, so I will stop the session for this. Any other queries in this session? We'll check out tomorrow.
Okay, Anuj, yeah, maybe we'll ask the question tomorrow.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Okay, perfect. Okay, I will close the recording for this session then.
Okay.
Okay, so Binod, you had some queries you can ask now.
No.